kids are trying to communicate with us, and the better we understand kids as a society, the better situations are for children. And so we do a lot where we're looking at how parents communicate with their children, both in typically developing children and autism spectrum disorder. We're looking at not necessarily what the children can produce, but what they're understanding and how parents are describing things to their kids.
The goals of our research are really to understand how kids learn language, and for kids who are struggling to learn language, how we can support them, how we can make it easier. We developed this new kind of experimental paradigm where we're using our very precise eye tracking methods to study language comprehension in kids, but the language that they're hearing, that we're asking them to comprehend, comes from their own parent. So we have this game design where we ask the child to find things that their parent points out to them, and then we can see how well the child understands what the parent is saying.
My daughter was a little bit of a late talker, and she didn't say her first words until about 21 months. She did have an evaluation done, and she was not approved for services, but I'm a speech pathologist, and so I knew what to say, and I kind of pushed it a little bit. And the ironic thing is, between her second evaluation and her first therapy session, she started talking. I think about what I was feeling at that time and what other parents are feeling when they're having difficulty communicating with their child. So definitely we felt like we were helping.
So one thing I never thought of was like how descriptive you have to be. I should definitely be thinking more about what I say and how I say it. It's really interesting to see how like language can have impact and give so much information and insight into how one is growing up and like learning.